Can we have a question from the sister, please?
Hello, my name is Holly. I'm from the United States, where I received my degree in psychology. I would like to ask, how does modern science and the Quran align in the explanation of people being possessed by spirits?
The sister has a question. How does Quran and modern science look at it? What does it have to say about people being possessed by spirits? As far as modern science is concerned, I'm a medical doctor by training. I've given it up. I've changed from doctor of boy to doctor of soul. As far as medical science, it does not believe in being possessed by any spirit. They may give a medical terminology, they may be schizophrenia, they may be mental disorder, but there's no concept of human being possessed by spirit. Because science hasn't advanced so much that they've come to know that spirits exist. As far as the Quran is concerned, Islam is concerned, yes. Islam does believe that there are spirits. And a human being can be possessed by spirit. And that's the reason there were two surahs revealed in the Quran. The second last and the third last surah, second last and third last chapter, chapter number 112, chapter number 113, and chapter 114. The last two surahs, I'm sorry. The last two surahs of the Quran, chapter number 113 and chapter number 114, Surah Falak and Surah Nas. These two surahs, these two chapters were revealed as a treatment for this possession. A human being can be possessed by spirit. There is something like black magic. There is something like possession. We as Muslims should not be involved in controlling the spirit or controlling the jinns. It is prohibited. But there are people who do control jinns and do possess and do cause people to be possessed. This, in Islam, we should not indulge in it. But we can get possessed. And there are hadiths of the beloved Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam how to treat this. So there are people who are specialized, how you have medical doctors who are specialized in treating people who are ill. Like that in Islam, there are some people who are specialized in removing this possessed spirit. That's a separate specialty. How we have doctors of heart specialists separate, brain specialists separate, kidney specialists separate. Like that in Islam, we have certain people that are specialized, but unfortunately, sister, unfortunately, most of the people in the market who say that they remove the jinns, most of them are fraud. Unfortunately. And they are more to make a fast buck, fast money. There are very few which are authentic. To analyze and realize that they're authentic, if they're following what is mentioned in the Quran and the authentic hadith of the Prophet, that means they're authentic. These people won't run after the money. The other people are always running after money and trying to...